In this session, we will be discussing about the effectiveness and number of transfer unit of heat exchanger. We already learned about LMTD for heat exchanger, LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger, and LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger. And the heat exchanger can be designed by this method, LMTD method, when inlet and outlet conditions are specified. If the question or if the problem is to find out the inlet and outlet temperature, then we will be using another method, which is known as NTU method. So this method is based on effectiveness of heat exchanger. So what is this effectiveness of heat exchanger? So it is based on effectiveness, and this is expressed by the lecturer epsilon. And this, what is this effectiveness? Effectiveness is the ratio between actual heat transfer and maximum possible heat transfer. This is actual heat transfer divided by maximum possible heat transfer. Maximum possible heat transfer. Okay, or we can represent this effectiveness as Q by Q max. So what is this Q? Q is the actual heat transfer for a heat exchanger, and Q, we know that Q can be found out using the equation m dot h cph th1 minus th2. This is the heat which is lost from the hot fluid. M dot h is the mass flow rate of hot fluid, CPH is the specific heat, TH1 is the inlet condition of hot fluid, and TH2 is the outlet condition of hot fluid, and this is equal to M dot C CPC TC2 minus TC1, because TC2 is greater than TC1. So this is from this equation you can find out Q or UA theta, that is UA theta, or you can use this equation UA theta. So all this equation, from this all equation, we will get the value of Q. Then what is this maximum possible heat transfer, Q max? So Q max, we can, if you analyze the temperatures, we have four temperatures for hot fluid, inlet and outlet, for cold fluid, inlet and outlet. TC1 is the cold fluid inlet, and TC2 is the cold fluid outlet. So among these four temperatures, the maximum temperature is TH1, because it is the hot fluid inlet temperatures, and the least one is TC1, it is the cold fluid inlet temperature. So the maximum possible temperature difference for this heat exchanger is TH1 minus TC1. This is the maximum possible temperature difference, maximum possible temperature difference for a heat exchanger. Then what would be the maximum possible heat transfer? The Q would be, the Q maximum would be TH1 minus TC1. So this can be expressed as MH into CPH is CH, and MC into CPC is equal to CC, heat capacity for hot fluid and heat capacity of cold fluid. So if the temperature difference into heat capacity will give the maximum heat transfer. So TH1 minus TC1 is the maximum possible temperature difference. So then we have to add CH or CC into this. If you multiply CH or CC by TH1 minus TC1, we will get Q maximum. So which one will be that, CH or CC? So the answer is, we have to select the minimum. So we have to find out the value of CH, and we have to select the value of CC, and if which one is minimum, that would be C minimum. Okay, so Q max is equal to C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. This is the maximum possible heat transfer for a heat exchanger, because this is the maximum possible heat temperature difference, and the temperature difference, the maximum temperature difference should be associated with the minimum heat capacity. If the heat capacity is the heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So the heat capacity is high means the temperature difference is very less. If the temperature difference is very high, the difference between the temperature are more, which means the heat capacity should be minimum. So we will select the minimum heat capacity among CH and CC, then we can find out the Q maximum. So Q max is equal to C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. So the effectiveness now is equal to, it is CH into TH1 minus TH2 divided by C minimum TH1 minus TC1, or CC into TC2 minus TC1 divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. The effectiveness, we have two equations to find out the effectiveness. One is CH into TH1 minus TH2 divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1, or CC into TC2 minus TC1 divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. So where C minimum is minimum of CH and CC. So we will find out the value of CH, then we will find out the value of CC. So which is minimum? If CH is minimum, we will substitute it as CH. Okay, if CC is minimum, it would be CC. If CC is minimum, this equation is CH into TH1 minus TH2, CC into TH1 minus TC. If you use this equation, the CC will get cancelled, though then these are the terms remaining. Okay, if CH is the minimum one, then the effectiveness would be TH1 minus TH2 into TH1 minus TC1. Okay, so that is all about the effectiveness. Now we are going to find out the effectiveness for parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay, effectiveness for parallel flow heat exchanger. So we are using an NTU method. So you are very familiar with this figure right now. This is the temperature distribution or temperature profile for a parallel flow heat exchanger. The hot fluid temperature is reducing from TH1 to TH2, while the cold fluid, which is entering the same direction, the temperature is increasing from TC1 to TC2. So this is the heat transfer equation for this small area dA. dQ is the heat transfer in that area dA. So dQ is equal to m dot h Cph dTh. So we are adding a minus sign because the temperature is decreasing, and which is equal to m dot c Cpc dTc, and this is equal to UdA theta. This equation we have seen LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger. So we can rewrite this equation as dQ is equal to mh Cph minus ch dTh is equal to Cc into dTc. So from this equation, I can write dTh as minus dQ by CH, and dTc as dQ by CC. And if I subtract dTc from dTh, so that is dTh minus dTc, which is equal to minus dQ by CH minus dQ by CC. Same steps of this parallel flow LMTD. We are following the same steps. Then we can take this minus dQ outside. So minus dQ into 1 by CH. If you take minus dQ outside, plus 1 by CC. So dTh minus dTc is equal to minus dQ 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. Okay. That is dTh minus dTc is equal to minus dQ 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So dTh minus dTc, TH minus TC is equal to theta. So dTh minus dTc, same step of LMTD, dTh minus dTc is equal to d theta, which is equal to minus dQ 1 by CH plus 1 by cc. Or now I am going to substitute for this dq. What is this dq? Dq is equal to u da theta. So I am substituting for this dq. So d theta is equal to minus u da theta into 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. So I can take d theta into this side. So that is d theta by theta, theta into this side. Okay, minus u da 1 by ch 1 by cc. So next step is, as in the case of LMTD, next step is integrating. So theta is changing from, sorry, d theta is changing from theta 1 to theta 2, and da is changing from 0 to a. So I'm giving the limit as d theta by theta, theta 1 to theta 2, inlet to outlet condition, minus u, the total area is, so I'm taking the constant 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. So this is integral dA 0 to total area A. The area is changing from 0 to total area A. So this is 1 by theta d theta, that is log theta, and applying the limit log theta 2 by theta 1, that is ln theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to minus ua 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. Okay, and now I am going to substitute the values of, till now the steps are same as LMTD, now the steps are changing. Now I am going to give the values for this theta 2. What is theta 2? The theta 2 for theta 2 is for, this is theta 2, this is theta 2, and the temperature difference, this is theta 1. Okay, this is theta 1 and this is theta 2. So the temperature difference, TH2 minus TC2 is theta 2, and the temperature difference inlet condition, TH1 minus TC1 is theta 1. So I'm going to substitute that values here. So log TH2 minus TC2 divided by TH1 minus TC1 is equal to minus ua 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. Or I can write this as th2 minus tc2 by th1 minus tc1 is equal to e raised to, so e raised to minus ua 1 by ch plus 1 by cc. Okay, now we are going to substitute the values of th2 and tc2 in the terms of effectiveness. So this is the equation. I'm just naming this equation as 1. Now I'm stopping here, and now I'm continuing with the effectiveness, because I want a substitution for TC2 and TH2 and TC2 in terms of effectiveness. So what is this effectiveness? The effectiveness is equal to CH into TH1 minus TH2 divided by C minimum into the maximum possible temperature difference, TH1 minus TC1, or is equal to CC into TC2 minus TC1 divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. So from this equation, from the equation of effectiveness, we have to find out substitution for TH2 and TC2. So for finding out the substitution for TH2, I am using this equation, that is effectiveness is equal to CH into TH1 minus TH2 into C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. So from this equation, I can write this equation as CH into TH1 minus TH2 is equal to effectiveness into C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. Okay, and TH1 minus TH2 is equal to effectiveness into C minimum by CH TH1 minus TC1. Okay, so from this equation TH1 minus TH2 is equal to effectiveness into C minimum by CH into TH1 minus TC2. So what is TH2? So TH2 can be TH2 is equal to TH1. So I'm taking TH2 into this side and I'm taking this term into this side. So TH2 is equal to TH1 minus effectiveness into C minimum. Effectiveness C minimum divided by CH into TH1 minus TC1. Okay. And to find out an equation for TC1, so we can type this equation. Effectiveness is equal to CC into TC2 TC1 by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. So T, that equation, I can again take this equation as CC into TC2 minus TC1 divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. Okay, and this equation can be effective CC into TC2 minus TC1 is equal to effectiveness C minimum TH1 minus TC1, and TC2 minus TC1 is equal to effectiveness C minimum by CC TH1 minus TC1. So TC2 is equal to TC1 plus effectiveness C minimum by CC TH1 minus TC1. So we have got substitution for TC2 as this and a substitution for TH2 as this. So we have this equation 1, TH2 minus TC2 by TH1 minus TC1 is equal to e raised to minus UA by 1 plus CH plus 1 by CC. Okay, now I'm going to substitute for TH2 and TC2 in this equation. So TH2 we have TH1 minus, so I'm rewriting this equation by substituting TH2 and TC2. So for LHS, left hand side, TH2, for TH2 I have TH1 minus TH1 minus C minimum TH1 minus TC1 divided by CH. This is the term TH2, and TH2 minus TC2. So TC2 for TC2, TC1 plus effectiveness C minimum CC TH1 minus TC1. Okay, divided by TH1 minus TC1, and this is equal to e raised to minus UA 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So I'm rearranging this equation. So TH1 minus TC1, and okay, I'm taking TC1, TH1 minus TC1, TH1 minus TC1, then minus of, I can take this effective ends into C minimum as common. So this is minus of effective ends of C minimum, TH1 minus TC1, again it is common, TH1 minus TC1. So here it is minus, here it is also minus. So what is remaining? 1 by CH, 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. 1 by CC. So divided by, again, TH1 minus TC1 is equal to e raised to minus UA 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. And TH1 minus TC1, this is common. I can take this TH1 minus TC1 outside. So TH1 minus TC1 divided by TH1 minus TC1. So if I take this as common, this is 1 minus effectiveness C minimum into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC is equal to minus UA 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So this is cancelled. TH1 minus TC1 is common, so this can be cancelled. So the remaining is 1 minus effectiveness into C minimum into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC is equal to e raised to minus UA 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So from this equation, I can write the effectiveness into C minimum 1 by CH plus 1 by CC is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus UA by 1 by CH plus 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. And the effectiveness is equal to, and this effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to, so I'm taking this CH outside, so this becomes 1 plus CH by CC divided by C minimum into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So this is the equation I have got for effectiveness for parallel flow heat exchanger. 1 minus e raised to minus UA by CH plus 1 plus CH by CC, C minimum into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So I'm taking a one condition. If CC is greater than CH, or CH is less than CC, which means the C minimum is equal to CH. C minimum is equal to CH, and CC would be C max. So I can rewrite this equation as now. Effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus UA by CH. Now I am substituting C minimum and into 1 plus CH C minimum by C maximum divided by C minimum into 1 by C minimum plus 1 by CC, C max. Okay. Or this is equal to 1 minus UA by C minimum, 1 plus C minimum by C maximum divided by 1. I'm opening this bracket, C minimum by C minimum 1 plus C minimum by C max. So I'm taking one condition, if CC is less than CH, so I will be getting the epsilon that is effective and says 1 minus e raised to my UA by C minimum, 1 plus C minimum by C max divided by 1 plus C minimum by C max. Okay. If the condition is if CH is greater than CC, then CC is C minimum and CH is C maximum. Okay, let's see how it is. Then effectiveness is equal to, the effectiveness is equal to, you can see 1 minus e raised to minus UA by CH is now C maximum, 1 plus C maximum by C minimum, and denominator C minimum into 1 plus 1 by CH, 1 by CH is 1 by C max plus 1 by C minimum. So the new denominator would be the same, because here 1 by C minimum plus 1 by C max, there 1 by C maximum plus 1 by C minimum. So denominator would be the same if CH is equal to C max. So 1 plus C minimum by C max. So numerator is equal to 1 minus exponential of 1 minus UA by C max, 1 plus C max by C minimum divided by, denominator would be the same, C minimum by C max, because 1 by C max plus 1 by C minimum, that would be the same. And if I check the numerator part, this is C max into 1 plus C max by C minimum. That means if I take C minimum outside, if I take C minimum outside and C max into the bracket, that is effectiveness is equal to, effectiveness is equal to 1 minus exponential e raised to 1 minus UA by C minimum. I have taken C minimum outside. So if I take C minimum outside, so this is C minimum. Okay. I'm just taking C max into C minimum. Okay, C minimum outside. So this would be C minimum plus C max. Okay. And now I'm taking C max inside. This C max inside. So I'm just taking the C max from here. So this would be C max by plus C max divided by 1 plus C minimum by C max. Okay, and what is this C minimum by C max? C minimum by C max plus C max by C max. C max by C max, this term is equal to 1. So this would be, if CH is greater than CC, effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus UA by C minimum into 1 plus C minimum by C max divided by 1 plus C minimum into C max. That is both this equation, this equation 2 and this equation 3, that is 2 is equal to 3. So no matter if CC is greater than CH or CH is greater than CC, the effectiveness would be the same, and that would be effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus UA by C minimum into 1 plus C minimum by C max divided by 1 plus C minimum by C max, which means the effectiveness depends on three parameters. The first one is UA by C minimum, and second one is C minimum by C max, and third one is the flow arrangement. If the flow arrangement is parallel, the effective units would be like this. If it is counter, we will get another term. So it depends on the effective units, depends on three parameters. The first one is the term UA by C minimum, and second term is C minimum by C max, and the third parameter is flow arrangement. The effectiveness depends on three parameters. The one is the first one is UA by C minimum. This is a dimensionless expression, and this is known as NTU or number of transfer unit. The dimensionless term UA by C minimum is termed as NTU, number of transfer units. So UA by C minimum is equal to NTU, and the term C minimum by C max, which is known as capacity ratio. Capacity ratio expressed by the letter R. So C minimum by C max is expressed by the letter R, and this is expressed by the letter expressed by NTU. So now I can write the effective units. The third one is flow arrangement. Okay, so now I can write the effectiveness as 1 minus e raised to minus UA by C minimum is equal to minus NTU into 1 plus C minimum by C max, that is 1 plus R divided by 1 plus R. So the effectiveness for a parallel flow is equal to 1 minus E raised to minus NTU into 1 plus R divided by 1 plus R. This is the equation for effectiveness of parallel flow. Heat exchanger, 1 minus E raised to minus NTU. NTU is equal to UA by C minimum plus 1 plus R. R is equal to C minimum by C max divided by 1 plus R. Okay, in this session we will be discussing about the effectiveness for a counter flow heat exchanger, and this is the temperature profile for a counter flow heat exchanger. The hot fluid, the temperature of hot fluid is decreasing from TH1 to TH2, and the cold flow is entering from the outlet side, and the outlet side of hot fluid, and its temperature is increasing from TC1 to TC2. From outlet to inlet it is increasing, but inlet to outlet it is decreasing. The temperature of cold flow is decreasing. So we can write the heat transfer equation as dq is equal to, for this dA area, minus mh cph dth is equal to minus mc cpc dtc, which is equal to the heat transfer equation for heat exchanger uda theta. And the minus signs is because the temperature is decreasing in both cases, and we can rewrite this equation as dq is equal to minus cc dtc, or is equal to minus ch dth, and dth is equal to minus dq by ch, and dtc is equal to minus dq by cc, and we can write dth minus dtc is equal to minus dq by ch minus plus dq by cc, or dth minus dtc is equal to, I can take minus dq outside, minus dq 1 by ch minus 1 by cc. Okay, that is dth minus dtc is equal to, instead of dq I can substitute uda theta 1 by ch minus 1 by cc, and dth minus dtc is equal to d theta. So d theta, I can take theta into this side, so theta is equal to minus u 1 by ch minus 1 by cc da. So I can integrate d theta by theta or theta 1 to theta 2 and dA to 0 to A, same steps. So d theta by theta is equal to log theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to minus UA 1 by CH minus 1 by CC. Okay, and now we can substitute for theta 2 and theta 1 for counter flow heat exchanger. Theta 2 is equal to TH1 minus TC2 and theta 2 is equal to TH2 minus TC1. So I can substitute log theta 2 as log TH2 minus TC1 divided by and TH1 minus TC2 is equal to minus UA 1 by CH minus 1 by CC, or TH2 minus TC1, TH1 minus TC2 is equal to minus UA 1 by CH minus 1 by CC. So this is the equation. And now next step is we need to have a substitution for TH2 and TC2 in terms of effectiveness. And we know that the effectiveness is equal to CH into TH2 minus TH1 minus TH2 by C minimum TH1 minus TC1 is equal to CC TC2 minus TC1 divided by C minimum TH1 minus TC1. So like in the previous cases, we have to have a substitution for TH2 and TC2 from this equation, and we have the substitution as, so from that equation we will get the substitution as TH2 is equal to TH1 minus effectiveness into C minimum by CH TH1 minus TC1, and TC2 as TC1 plus effectiveness C minimum by CH by TH1 minus TC1. Now we are going to substitute the values of TH2 and TC2 in the previous equation. This equation, we are going to substitute the values of TH2 and TC2. TH2 is numerator and TC2 is in the denominator. So the equation will become TH2 is equal to TH1 minus effectiveness C minimum by C max into TH1 minus TC1 minus, this is the first thing, minus TC1 divided by TH1 minus TC2, that is TC1 plus effectiveness C minimum by CH TH1 minus TC1 is equal to e raised to UA e raised to minus UA. Okay. Here there is one condition. There is e, this is not minus UA, this is e raised to minus UA by 1 by CH minus 1 by CC. So instead of e raised to, I am using exponential. So this is equal to e raised to minus UA 1 by CH minus 1 by CC. Okay. Okay, in this equation we can see TH1 minus TC1 here, and in the denominator also TH1 minus TC1. So, and in this term also there is a TH1 minus TC1. That means we can take this TH1 minus TC1 as a common. So, TH1 minus TC1. So, TH1 minus TC1. If I take TH1 minus TC1, the term is 1 minus C minimum by okay, this is not C max, this is CH, sorry, this is CH, C minimum by CH into divided by here TH1 minus TC1, 1 minus C minimum by, okay, this is here it is CC, okay, and here it is CC. So the two correction, TC2, this is CC, so this is 1 minus C minimum by CC, so please correct it. So TC2 is not CH, this is TC, and here also not Cmax, CH, here CC, is equal to e raised to, so I'm just rearranging, so I'm to avoid this negative sign, so this is equal to UA 1 by CC minus 1 by CH. Okay. And this is again, this is okay. And I can cancel this TH1 minus TC1. So the remaining is 1 minus 1 minus effectiveness C minimum by CH divided by 1 minus effectiveness C minimum by CC is equal to E raised to, so I'm just taking CC outside, so UA by 1 by CC outside, so 1 minus CC by CH. So the equation, now we have got the equation as 1 minus effectiveness C minimum by CH, 1 minus effectiveness C minimum by CC is equal to E raised to UA by CC into 1 minus CC into CC by CH. Now I'm going to assume if CC is less than CH, that means CC is C minimum and CH is C max. Likewise, in the previous case, that is in the parallel flow heat exchanger, I am just assuming that CC is less than CH. I am not going to assume CH is less than CC because both are same. We have seen that in the case of parallel flow heat exchanger. So now CC is less than CH. So CC would be C minimum and CH would be C max. So that is 1 minus, the equation becomes effectiveness C minimum by C max divided by 1 minus effectiveness C minimum by C minimum is equal to E raised to UA by C minimum 1 minus C minimum by C max. Okay, this equation, we know that C minimum by C max, C minimum by C max can be written as R, heat capacity, and UA by C minimum would be NTU, and C minimum by C minimum is equal to 1. So applying that condition, 1 minus effectiveness into C minimum by C max is equal to R, 1 minus effectiveness is equal to E raised to NTU into 1 minus R. So from this equation, the effectiveness is we can rearrange this equation, 1 minus R is equal to 1 minus R is equal to E raised to 1 minus into 1 minus r into 1 minus r into 1 minus r minus effectiveness into e raised to minus into 1 minus r. Okay, and from this equation we can rearrange the epsilon terms into this side. So effectiveness is equal to, or 1 minus e raised to into 1 minus r is equal to effectiveness, can be taken common, r minus e raised to into 1 minus r. That is, effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to into 1 minus r divided by r minus e raised to into 1 minus r. Okay, now small adjustment and rearrangement. So I'm just taking it in reverse order, that is e raised to NTU into 1 minus r minus 1 is equal to e raised to NTU into 1 minus r minus r. Okay, just take the reverse, multiply by negative here, multiply negative, both are cancelled. So just take the reverse in numerator and denominator. Now I'm going to do some adjustment. I'm taking this first term as common. So that is exponential e raised to into 1 minus r. This is the first term which is common. So what would be the first term? 1. So this would be 1 minus 1 by e raised to into 1 minus r. So that is 1 by e raised to into 1 minus r can be written as e raised to minus of into 1 minus r. That is e raised to minus of into 1 minus r. Similarly, here also I am taking this first term as common. Here 1 minus r into e raised to minus NTU 1 minus r. This can be cancelled. So the remaining equation is, the effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU 1 minus r divided by 1 minus r into e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus r. So this is for counter, effectiveness for counter. Okay, the effectiveness for counter flow is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU 1 minus r divided by 1 minus r into e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus r, where in the case of parallel flow it is 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 plus r divided by 1 plus r. So now we are going to discuss some special cases. So if the capacity ratio r equal to 0, so this case is occurring in the case of condensers and evaporator, where the C maximum, the heat capacity in one side it is condensating or evaporating, means the temperature is not changing. If the temperature is not changing, means we are considering it as with high heat capacity, that is C maximum is equal to infinity in this case. The temperature is not changing. The heat capacity is the heat required to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius. If the temperature is not changing, means the heat capacity is infinity. So here C maximum is equal to infinity and R is equal to C minimum by C max. If C maximum is equal to infinity, R is approximately equal to 0. So for effectiveness, in this case, for parallel flow heat exchanger, the effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU, e raised to minus NTU, 1 plus 0, that is 1, so minus NTU into 1 divided by 1 plus 0, that is 1. So this is effectiveness for parallel flow heat exchanger. And in the case of counter flow heat exchanger, 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus R. So e raised to minus 1 minus e raised to minus NTU in the numerator and denominator 1 minus R. So R is here. So this becomes the whole term becomes 0. So 1 minus 0, 1. So in both cases, the effectiveness is same. That is 1 minus e raised to minus NTU. For condensers and evaporator, the effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU. And second case is when R equal to 1. That means R C minimum is equal to C max. C minimum is equal to C max, or both CH and CH is equal to CC. So, okay, CH is equal to CC, then we cannot find out a minimum or maximum. In that case, CH is equal to CC, that is M dot H CPH is equal to M dot C CPC. There is some chances are there for M dot H is equal to CPH, which is equal to, sorry, M dot H CPH is equal to M dot C CPC. That is CH is equal to CC. In this case, for parallel flow heat exchanger, so the equation is 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 plus R by 1 plus R. So 1 minus equation is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 2 divided by 2. But in the case of counter flow heat exchanger, the effectiveness is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus 1, that is 1 minus e raised to 0, that is 1 minus R into e raised to minus into 1 minus 1, that is 0, e raised to 0, 1. So this is 0 by 0. So we cannot determine the value of effectiveness in the case of counter flow heat exchanger using the 0 by 0. If 0 by 0, then we will apply L'Hospital rule. And for that, I am just rewriting this equation for counter flow heat exchanger. That's so the 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus R by 1 minus R into minus NTU into 1 minus R. So I'm just rewriting the equation in this form. So I'm going to rewrite this equation. The effectiveness we already derived, e raised to NTU into 1 minus R by e raised to NTU into 1 minus R minus 1. Okay, in this terms I'm rewriting. So this also can be e raised to NTU into 1 minus R minus 1 by e raised to NTU into 1 minus R minus R. Okay, this is the equation. Now I am going to apply R equal to limit R tends to 1. So you will get that is 0 by 0 form. So now I am going to apply the L'Hospital rule. I am taking the differential of numerator and denominator. So taking the differential of if I differentiate the numerator, so e raised to NTU into 1 minus R, if you differentiate R minus 1, you will get so that is minus minus 1, that is minus ntu, minus r into ntu, minus ntu into e raised to ntu into 1 minus r divided by minus 0 minus ntu into e raised to ntu into 1 minus r. So now I am apply the limit condition here. So when r tends to 1, this would be is equal to minus ntu into e raised to 1 minus r, that is 1 minus ntu into, okay, here minus r is there, so minus r is equal to minus 1, so this is minus 1. Okay, so the answer is equal to ntu by ntu plus 1, or ntu by 1 plus ntu. So here just taking the differential, just differentiate the e raised to ntu into 1 minus r, minus r minus the derivative of minus r is equal to, or r is equal to 1, and the derivative of e raised to ntu into 1 minus r is equal to minus ntu into e raised to ntu into 1 minus r. So we will get the effectiveness for counter flow heat exchanger if r equal to 1 as ntu into 1 plus ntu. Okay, so effectiveness is equal to ntu into 1 plus ntu if r equal to 1 for counter flow. Okay, that's it.